if you wanted to class me, you could put me as a Muslim.
Well, I'm not going to class you. I'm not going to classify you.
No, but I'm saying if you want to...
Let me make it easier for you.
Okay, go on then.
Why don't you classify yourself?
Okay, I do.
What are you?
I surrender to God.
Are you a Muslim?
Of course not, because I surrender to God. It's eternal, isn't it?
Then. If you believe that you're a Muslim...
Through surrender.
Know that.
I'm a surrender.
Not just that. With that comes now an utterance. With that comes an utterance.
Yeah,
it doesn't merely reside in the heart. I'll tell you.
Okay, yeah, man.
And if you want to repeat it after me, that would be even better.
I will gladly repeat it to you.
Right.
The
utterance is
in
this.
Essence, people get it.
The utterance is this. I'll say it in English first. That I bear witness that none
has the right
to be worshipped
except Allah alone.
And I bear witness
that Muhammad
is the finality of the prophets.
Of the prophets.
Now, based upon that utterance, with a person comprehending what he said, he enters into the fold of Islam and he becomes a Muslim.
Absolutely. You surrender.
Right?
Those utterances were necessary.
Now,
I agree with you.
Now, as for what remains in your heart, I can't judge. I don't know what's in your chest. It's quite possible. Not saying you did. It's possible for a person to lie and utter upon his tongue what is not in his chest.
Absolutely.
But I'm not going to take that. I take what is apparent.
Absolutely.
I'm going to take that as apparent.
That's all we can deal with.
Alhamdulillah.
We have to trust each other a little bit and not be suspicious of each other. Because we're suspicious of each other.
Now that you've become doubtful. Now that you were a Muslim previously and you've even reaffirmed your faith now, right? That's what you're saying.
Because I think the important part is this surrender, the absolute surrender.
And this is my point.
If you truly
that none has the right to be worshipped. And when I say worship, I'm going to explain. I'm going to give you the definition. One of the great scholars of Islam, his name's Sheikh Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, he defined worship in this way. He said, "Ismun jamin li kulli ma yuhibbuhu Allahu wa yarḍah." He said, "It is a comprehensive term which includes everything which Allah loves and is pleased with." Right?